Before we dive into a discussion of optics and how optical principles apply to solar cells, we have to start with the fundamental constituents of light. These are two phenomena that have been known to us since ancient times, namely electricity and magnetism. This video will be a brief introduction to Maxwell equations that are the basis for electromagnetic theory. You need not completely understand every detail of every equation, but this is a useful video to start off with. This video might also be useful to come back to if you need help with the optic applications that are specifically relevant for solar cells. The learning objectives of this video are to understand how electricity and magnetism are related to light. To that end, we will create an understanding of the Maxwell equations and of some of the concepts involved. Finally, we will see how the propagation of light is derived from the Maxwell equations. It took us until the 19th century to realize that electricity and magnetism are two sides of the same coin that we call electromagnetism. Both are related to charge. We can recall that electric fields are generated by charges, while magnetic fields are generated by moving charges or currents. Let us now assume that we are within an array of charges indicated by the small circles. Since charges themselves create an electric field, we will experience such a field. Now, we indicate here by the black on the green figure, start moving with a constant velocity. Us moving with respect to the charges is equivalent to saying that the array of charges move with respect to us. Since moving charges are the definition of a current, we now experience a magnetic field. Thus, when changing from one frame of reference into another, electric fields are transformed into magnetic fields and vice versa. Between 1861 and 1862, the Scottish physicist James Clerk Maxwell published works in which he managed to formulate the complete electromagnetic theory by a set of equations. He combined Gauss' law for magnetism, Faraday's law of induction, and Ampere's circuit law into what is known as the Maxwell equations. One of the most important predictions of this set of equations is the presence of electromagnetic waves. Maxwell soon realized that light itself is an electromagnetic wave. Before discussing the actual Maxwell equations, however, we will look into the concept of displacement and induction. Electric displacement occurs in any dielectric material. A dielectric is an electrical insulator that can be polarized by an applied electric field. When a dielectric is placed in an electric field, denoted by E, electric charges do not freely flow through the material as they do in a conductor. Instead, the charges, the nuclei and bound electrons of which the dielectric consists, only slightly shift from their average equilibrium positions. Positive charges are displaced in the direction of the electric field, and negative charges shift in the opposite direction. The displacement induces a local electric dipole moment. The sum of all these dipole moments creates an internal electric field indicated by D, in the opposite direction of the applied external electric field. The electric displacement, therefore, reduces the overall field within the dielectric itself. The electric displacement is related to the electric field via the shown equation. Here, epsilon is the relative permittivity of the medium in which the fields are observed, and epsilon naught is the vacuum permittivity. The product gives the absolute permittivity of a material. Similarly, a magnetic material can cause a magnetic induction, indicated by B. The magnetic field, denoted by H, and the induction B are related to each other through the shown equation. Mu is the relative permeability of the medium in which the fields are absorbed, and mu naught is the permeability of the free space. Note, however, that these equations are only valid if the medium is isotropic. So epsilon and mu are independent of the direction of either field. We can assume that all solar cell materials are non-magnetic. This means that for solar cell materials, mu is equal to 1. Before looking into the Maxwell equations, we will discuss the concept of divergence. We use divergence to account for the three-dimensional nature of the fields. The divergence is a scalar function of vector field. The divergence of a vector field is therefore proportional to the density of point sources of the field. The divergence of a random vector function v is the sum of the rates of change of v in the x, y, and z directions. The four Maxwell equations couple the electric and magnetic fields to their sources, namely the electric charges and the current densities, and to each other. The divergence of the electric displacement at a certain time and location equals the free charge density at that location. T and R denote the respective time and location, whereas rho F denotes the free charge density. The divergence of the electric field equals the change in the magnetic induction over time, whereas the divergence of the magnetic inductions at a certain location and time does not change. This implies that the magnetic inductions has no point sources. Finally, the divergence of the magnetic field equals the change of the electric displacement over time, plus the free current density denoted by JF. Maxwell realized that this set of equations predicts the existence of electromagnetic waves. Following in his footsteps, we will now derive these wave equations. We will do that in source-free space, so in a certain volume, absent of any point sources of charge and current. The free charge density and free current density, therefore, both equal zero. Since we are after the propagation of the wave, we are interested in the derivative of the electric field. We therefore start by applying the rotation operator, which is the reverse triangle, to the second Maxwell equation. To simplify the left-hand side, we introduce the upward triangle for the derivative of the divergence of the electric field vector function. We can obtain the expression for the change of the magnetic inductions over time by using the fourth Maxwell equation. We rewrite this equation by making use of the definitions of the electric displacement and magnetic induction that we discussed earlier. When we remember that the free current density is set to zero, we arrive at the following equation. This version of the fourth Maxwell equation provides a definition of the divergence of the magnetic induction. If you combine this relation with the derivative of the second Maxwell equation, we obtain the wave equation for the electric field. This wave equation can be further simplified by realizing that 1 over the speed of light in vacuum squared equals the permittivity times the permeability in vacuum. A similar derivation can be executed for the magnetic field function, arriving at the shown equation. The simplest solution to the wave equation is the plane harmonic wave. For a plane harmonic wave, light of a constant wavelength propagates in one direction. We can name this the y direction as a matter of convention. The propagation in the electric field of a plane harmonic wave is described by the shown equation. E naught is a constant vector describing the wave amplitude. K is the wave number and omega is the angular frequency measured in radians per second. By substituting the second equation in the first equation, we find that the wave number, which is measured in radians per meter, is connected to the angular frequency. This relation involves the speed of light in vacuo, denoted by C0, and the refractive index of the material through which the light wave propagates, denoted by N. The latter will be discussed more extensively later in the course. The wave number and angular frequency are related to other wave properties, like the wavelength measured in meters and wave frequency measured in hertz. These equations show how all four wave properties are related through pi, the speed of light in vacuo, and the refractive index of the propagation media. Note that the wave frequency and angular frequency are independent of the refractive index, while the wave number and wavelength change when the wave travels to media with a different refractive index. The plane harmonic solutions of Maxwell's wave equation, shown in the lower right corner, describe how light propagates through oscillations in electric and magnetic fields. Extensive derivations of the Maxwell equations describe some extraordinary properties of the electromagnetic waves. These properties are well illustrated by this animation. The electric and magnetic field vectors are perpendicular to each other, and also perpendicular to the propagation vector. Finally, the electric and magnetic vectors have a constant material-dependent ratio. This ratio, but denoted by Z0, is called the impedance of free space and is equal to the electric field strength divided by the magnetic field strength. Through the peaks and troughs in the electric and magnetic fields, light will propagate in a corkscrew motion. It will propagate in a singular direction until such a time at which it encounters a different medium. So, as a recap, we saw how electricity and magnetism are two sides of the same electromagnetism coin. We discussed the concept of displacement and inductions, and saw how these concepts affect the magnetic and electric field strengths through the Maxwell equations. From the Maxwell equations, we derived the electromagnetic wave equations, and we saw how the electromagnetic wave propagates through an oscillation in an electric field and an oscillation in the magnetic fields. With all of this in mind, we can now continue onto a different optical phenomena, and specifically how they relate to solar cells.